Rant about Reccembran reproduction, part 1. Here we'll discuss the reproductive system used by many Eudaimonians, especially those multicellular. It's called the three-sex reproductive system, and is used by coralliforms and exoanimals. The purpose of this system is to make sure reproduction is possible by having an almost equal amount of each sex. This is achieved by how gametes work. Gametes only have half of a functional cell, meaning they have to mix with a gamete of the opposite sex to make a complete cell and start creating an embryo. There are only two gametes, once with the cell stem, and once with everything else. Once the gametes merge, an interesting process begins happening. Each gamete has one sex-determining molecule on it, and depending on where these molecules are, the organism becomes one sex or the other. These molecules are made out of RNA, and surprisingly, also DNA, the only use of DNA in Reccembran life, and can be turned into each other by special enzymes. Supposing these molecules are called A and B, if A is in the cell stem and B is in the cell wall, the organism becomes a male, which will only produce cell stem gametes. If B is in the cell stem and A is in the cell wall, the organism becomes a female, only producing the other type of gamete. If both the molecules are the same, AA or BB, the organism becomes a hermaphrodite, capable of producing both gametes. Gametes work like this. If the gamete maker cells, cells making up the reproductive tissue, contain the male combination of molecules, the cell splits off its cell stem as a gamete, and then dies, getting recycled by the organism. If it has the female combination, the cell leaves its cell stem behind and becomes a gamete. If both the signal molecules are the same, the cell splits in half and both its halves become gametes. It is important to note that before a gamete gets released, special enzymes randomize its single sex determiner molecule, allowing it to stray from its mother cell combination.